Hi, Barrett Jones here, record producer. I'm really sad today. I just found out Mark Lanegan has passed, and it's very sad to hear. He's basically the same age as I am, and while I've never got the chance to actually work directly with him, I definitely have met him many times and toured with his bands. In when I was with Nirvana, they used to play with us, and every time I've had a conversation with them, he was always the nicest, most genuine, really just lovely guy. And it's really sad to hear another one gone before their time. I don't know what happened. I know that he had a really bad time with COVID a few months ago and was not over the effects of that. I don't know if that had anything to do with it, but anyway, it's just really sad. He was a very talented guy, and that's a lot of Seattle singers have left us way before their time. I don't know. I don't know what I wanted to say. I mean, I'm just very sad about this, and I don't know what to talk about. But I did want to just remember a story from the Reading Festival in '92 when the Screaming Trees played. This was a crazy show. I mean, there was just so many crazy things happening that day. Mudhoney was there. L7 was there. Screaming Trees and Nirvana, who I was working with at the time, were headlining the night that I was there. And the Screaming Trees had an incident where, and I do believe there was some alcohol on board. But Mark had taken the end of the end of his microphone stand and smashed it into the camera that was down in the pit. And it was one of those very expensive, like TV type massive cameras. And I think they got in a lot of trouble for that. But they were just being, doing what rock stars do. I don't think it was malicious. I'm pretty sure it was not malicious at all. But it was unfortunate. And I also wanted to, I think there was a good laugh afterwards, but I also wanted to just talk about one of my favorite songs of his, Hanging Tree, with when he was with Queens of the Stone Age. Thought we could listen to a little bit of it. It's just so good. His voice was so silky and smooth, and he just is so good at that stuff. Like, really. This song is just so nice. I mean, it's one of my favorite records, especially of, it's definitely my favorite Queens record. Funny enough though, I don't like the drum sound on this record. they did an interesting thing where they didn't, the cymbals were played afterwards. So when they recorded the drums, they just recorded the kick, the snare, and the rack toms with no cymbals, no hi-hat, no cymbals, no nothing. And that was overdubbed later. And there's a very good reason for doing this. This is, you know, it's not totally unheard of to do that. And you should be able to get good boomy room sounds for all the toms and the snares and stuff without getting cymbal bleed. But for some reason, the drum sounds just sound weird to me. I don't like it. But the songs are fucking amazing, especially this one, because of Mark Lanegan's voice and his whole vibe. So good. I mean, not many singers can have a silky, smooth, low voice like that. And Mark was one of a kind. One of a kind. Anyway, I just wanted to talk about it for a second. It's don't know how to process this. It's very sad that another one from Seattle, from one of the many amazing bands that came from here, has now passed. And I wish the best to all my friends who knew him well and his family. And all right. Thanks for stopping by.